Senator Espada.
Thank you, Madam President. I want to begin by thanking these chambers, all 62 senators, whose own growth, political evolution, climaxed not too long ago to allow a debate on a bill whose destiny has not been predetermined to have this kind of glorious debate and this kind of sharing of thought and of our core values. If this vote were taken in my district today, same-sex marriage, marriage equality would fail. Reverend Diaz is correct about that. Our districts abut. We are primarily very, very poor, very, very African-American, Latino. We have the highest jobless rate in the state, over 14% unemployment in our county. But this is not about demographics. Others have talked about this not being a matter of religion or morality. I just want to dedicate a couple of minutes to those senators who have not made up their mind, because my mind has been made up a long, long time ago. Despite the flavor of this issue in my community that has children in schoolyards beating each other up because one may look too effeminate, because we're taught upon being delivered on this earth that we're not to have and enjoy certain toys or certain dolls. In other words, it is so intrinsic and embedded in our DNA as a culture, as a society, that it has truly a life of its own. But the matter has a life of its own here today. And the headlines that will be written are not just about a historic debate because we happen to have matured to that level, but as to whether or not this is truly a vote of conscience, my undecided colleagues. Is it a vote of conscience? What is this thing called a conscience? It's that little voice, right, in all of us when we were growing up. That's right. What is right and what is wrong? Little boy, little girl. We all grow up with that. You don't have to have a high school diploma, a GED, a BA, a PhD. It is that inner voice that no matter how old you get or how dumb you remain, that's what's going, or how smart you get, that's what's going to predetermine that vote of conscience. It is constitutionally correct to vote yes. Yeah, I think it's morally correct to vote yes. Don't talk to me about not legislating morality. I understand that we build walls and we build signs, but we do that all the time. But let's not be scared into ignorance to think that it is not morally correct to allow same-sex couples to enjoy the same rights as opposite-sex couples. That may take a long time to sink in and become part of the social and cultural fabric, but so be it. It is historically correct. The drumbeat and the precedents that have been cited are correct. We have rationed out equal rights, civil rights, for many, many, many years. States have adopted certain things at certain points. I mean, Iowa doing things on farm workers' rights decades ago. Personally, I'm disappointed that we continue to ration out a debate on human rights. I'd love to have a comprehensive agenda of human rights be voted on this floor that would include domestic workers, most of them black and brown, farm workers, most of them black and brown. I would love, so we're not done. But that, as it relates to today, undecided senators, let's write this headline for the New York Times, for the Daily News, for the Post, for El Diario. Let's write this headline for my 10th grandchild, whose sonogram was sent to me yesterday by my second son, in the fifth month of that pregnancy, we start to send off all of these messages. Let's send a message of hope. Let's set forth a drumbeat of equal rights for all by voting yes here today, and let's not continue to be scared into ignorance or pander to that in our communities. Madam President, I would vote yes and encourage those undecideds to vote yes as well. Thank you.